This is news to me, but water has more than just three phases. Like way, way more. And researchers here at the lab have not only been the first to experimentally create a particular new form of water in the lab with lasers, but have explored its atomic structure, also for the first time ever.
Water is liquid at ambient conditions, but you can generate ices by applying pressure and temperatures. So if you decrease the temperature below freezing, you generate water ice, which is the one we are mostly familiar with, water ice that we find in the refrigerator. But you can also form different form of ices by applying pressure and also both pressure and temperature, as superionic ice is the one that arises when you both compress and heat water to very high pressures and high temperatures.
So we all know that water is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, H2O, right? But we're talking about superionic ice here. It's what we call an exotic form of water, meaning we wouldn't find it under normal conditions here on Earth. And these exotic forms of water are made of the same ingredients as the water you and I know, but because of the extreme temperatures and pressures used to create exotic water, those same ingredients behave in a pretty surprising way, as both a liquid and a solid at the same time.
The oxygen keep behaving as a solid, so they form a crystalline solid lattice, but the hydrogen inside the water, the superionic water, the hydrogen start to jump from one oxygen to the other, and so they behave as a liquid. So to generate high pressures and temperature here at the lab, our specialty is to use giant lasers. We started with a liquid layer of water. We put it between two diamonds, and we focus those giant lasers onto a small target, about 1 millimeter spot size, and we deliver a lot of energy in a very short time, typically a few nanoseconds, so a few billionth of a second. And by delivering all that energy onto this small target in such a small time scale, we basically blow some of the material off. And by blowing some of the material off, we generate compression wave into the material.
The lasers generate shock waves that compresses and simultaneously hit the water layer, and the water starts undergoing structural changes, and in particular freezes into these superionic ice when you achieve the relevant pressure and temperature conditions.
And then just after a few billionths of a second later, we fire other lasers to create X-rays, and so that we can measure X-ray diffraction to really see and show to everyone that yes, crystals are forming at those conditions. And what is the structure? How are those atoms arranged in this crystal? It's not like a picture of the sample, but it's a pattern of in the data that tells us that yes, it is a crystal. So it's very clear if you have X-ray diffraction from a crystal or from a liquid. It's very obvious.
And while using lasers to generate those kinds of extreme conditions is a fascinating and challenging and complex process all on its own, the reasons we're interested in exploring exotic states of water in the first place are really important too.
A big portion of the icy giant planets are believed to be made by water mixtures. But water is, of course, not the liquid water we're familiar with, because the interior conditions of the icy giant planets are high pressure and high temperatures. So we need to understand how water modifies when it's subjected to these conditions.
Most of the matter in the universe is actually at high pressure and temperature, if you consider inside planets or inside stars. And so if we want to know about the origin of the solar system, the origin of the Earth, life on Earth, all these different questions, we need to know about materials at high pressure and temperatures.
So back in 2018, Marius and Federica and their team successfully created superionic ice in the lab for the first time ever. And this was a big deal, not only because it's really hard to make and to detect, but also because this form of matter was actually proposed decades ago as a possibility for what happens to water under these extreme temperatures and pressures. But until the team at the lab did it, no one had been able to experimentally confirm this hypothesis. So the actual creation of it means that we can not only successfully recreate here on Earth the kinds of conditions that are likely to exist inside of giant planets, which is just freaking cool, but also means that our computer models and simulations of what happens to matter at these extremes have actually been pretty spot on for a long time. And experiments like this can now feed more detail into those simulations so we can keep making them better and more accurate. As Marius and Federica said, this work also gives us a peek inside huge planets, which is important because it could answer big questions about why those planets are the way they are. Knowing more about the materials and the behavior of their interiors could tell us why they have the funky magnetic fields that they have, for example. So, what's next?
There are still many unknowns about the phase diagram of water. So what happens to liquid water when you compress it to much higher pressures than what we achieved in our study, keeping the temperature low. This is something that hasn't been proved by experiments yet, because achieving such pressures is very challenging.
And in particular, there is a series of new phases of solid ice that have been predicted at even higher pressure than the one we reached so far. And so we have plans to maybe go on the National Ignition Facility and push this experiment to reach, you know, new regime of pressure and temperature, and test predictions that have been made as well for new and even more complex structure of solid ice.
To catch all kinds of breaking science news coming out of the lab, make sure you follow us on our social media handles, where we post exciting scientific developments every day. If you want even more videos on our incredible high energy density science, make sure you leave a comment down below and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. Check out the rest of the Inside the Lab videos at this playlist over here. And as always, thank you so much for watching.